I built a scrollable text component for the terminal, and I decided to turn it into an NPM package.
This package allows you to create any number of scrollable boxes in the terminal, fits whatever content you give it inside, and makes it scrollable. This is the first of a series of weekly videos where I share the process of building an open source NPM package. I'm gonna show you the whole thing, including the challenges I found and how I sort them out.
Today we're going to call a simple proof of concept. The idea is to see how the project feels, what are the challenges we're maybe not seeing right away. In future videos, we will add a proper API, we'll add unit tests, continuous integration, documentation, and finally we're going to publish it to NPM. So let's get coding.
So a few months back, I got this idea of making an RSS reader for the terminal because, you know, why not? In case you're curious, many sites have this thing called RSS feed, which is basically an endpoint with their latest content in XML format. So if, for example, you visit my blog's RSS feed, you will find my latest articles. And so my terminal-based RSS reader allows users to pick any feeds they want, and then it reads these XMLs to create a single centralized feed. That way, you could read all your favorite blogs in a single place within your terminal. Problem is, as you can see, the content is usually HTML, so how do you render that in a terminal? Luckily, I found this library called CLI-HTML, which does exactly what I needed. It takes HTML and turns it into something that looks pretty nice in the terminal. So I decided to try it out. So the resulting content looks great, but it can be quite long, which causes that when I print it, it needs a scroll bar and even scrolls all the way to the bottom. Not exactly the experience I had in mind. And that's why I decided to make my own simple scrollable box that you can fully control with the keyboard and get rid of the scroll bar entirely. The initial problem seems simple enough, and as a developer, that's how you know you're probably missing something. So I thought it was a good idea to start with a quick proof of concept and see how it went. The goal of this proof of concept was simply to calculate where to split the text based on the window width, and only to show as many lines of text as we could fit based on the window height. Then, as the user presses the arrow keys, the box is re-rendered considering the new starting point. So let's get to work. So I reached this point where I had a version that kinda worked, but had some obvious problems. The text was scrolling up and down, and the scrollable area was placed correctly, but the text splitting was weird, and I could see some strange characters that appeared across the content. After some research, I learned that those are actually ANSI scapegoats, which take care of the styling, formatting, and other stuff in the terminal. As a quick test, I decided to try replacing the content with plain text, so I just pasted a few learn ipsum paragraphs in there, and that seemed to work mostly fine.
So we got something working. Yeah, we're obviously having some issues with the ANSI scapegoats. As we can see, that's going to be priority number one for next week. But on the plus side, we managed to place the text within the container we defined, as it's also not overlapping with the other elements in the screen, like the header there. And we got rid of the scrollbar at the side, which was the goal. So we made good progress so far. Next week we are going to fix that issue with the formatting. We are also going to work on the API to make it easier to set up a new scrollable area. So yeah, that's going to look a lot nicer next week. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and until next week, keep coding and have fun.